Hello designers, this is Rebecca, and today I'm going to show you how to create a sign template in Adobe Illustrator using Mike Stevens' natural layout formula. So let's get started. We're going to go ahead and create a new file from the Adobe Illustrator home screen. And when creating a sign template or starting a layout for a sign in Illustrator, I recommend taking the full dimensions of what your sign is actually going to be and scaling it down by 50 or 25% depending on how big it is. So if you try to make a 16 foot wide file in Illustrator, it will do it, but it's going to run really, really slow, especially as you start piling on more and more feature effects and, you know, all kinds of good stuff in there. So my sign is going to be 6 feet by 4 feet. So I'm going to go ahead and scale that into half. And since we're working with vectors, we can obviously enlarge it as much as we need without any pixelation or breakdown. So I would like you to hit print in the profiles along the top here. And for our units of measurement, go ahead and change that from points to feet and inches. Mine is going to be 3 feet wide because I'm cutting it in half. So I can just enter 3 in the width there. And for my height, it's going to be 2 feet high. And then for my orientation, mine is going to be a landscape orientation, but if yours is taller, obviously choose the portrait orientation. I don't need any bleeds for mine, but if your printer specified that they needed bleeds, then go ahead and please enter those here and then hit create. Great. So let me go ahead and show you the mastering layout formula here by Mike Stevens. This is from his book, Mastering Layout and on the Art of Eye Appeal. It's on Amazon. It's fantastic. I highly recommend it. There's even a Kindle version. So go and buy it now. And so in the book, this is just one of the little gems that he provides. This is the formula for laying out a natural layout sign. And as you can see here, the optical center, it's not actually 50% by 50%. It is 50% from the sides, but down, you want to make sure it's only 46% to establish your x-axis center, okay? Then from there, as you can see, the A's are 15% of your shortest axis. So in this example, the shortest axis is the y-axis or the vertical axis here. And then your B areas are going to be 17% of your horizontal axis. So even if your horizontal axis is shorter than your vertical axis, that's okay. You're gonna still use 17% of it, okay? So then from there, you are going to make sure that the bottom of your first group of text falls on this 29% line here. Then the bottom of your center text that is your highest in the information hierarchy is going to fall another 38% below that 29% line there. So then that leaves you with 33% from the bottom. And then to establish where the bottom of that third section of text is going to be, it says A plus 15%. And so to clarify, that doesn't mean 15% of the shortest axis plus another 15% of the shortest axis, that would equal 30%. What it means is 15% of the shortest axis plus 15% of that. So it's 15% of 15%. So that's basically 15% plus 2.25% is what that's going to look like. Okay. So let's go ahead and set this up in Illustrator using my 36 by 24 inch canvas, okay, or artboard. Great. So I went ahead and just left a little message there for us to remember. It's 36 by 24. I'd like you to please turn on your rulers. So to do that, you can hit Command R or Control R, or you can go to View, Rulers, and Show Rulers. The next thing that's important is go back into View, go to Guides, and choose Unlock Guides if you see the word unlock. And go ahead and click on that so it says lock guides like mine, okay? The other thing, I'm going to be using my transform panel. So go to Window and click on Transform if you can't see yours. Not all this information is available in the Properties panel today. All right. So we're just going to use our selection tool, and we're going to grab guides out of our rulers. So to do that, you just click on a ruler and slide it on over, and you'll see that guide appear. Since they're unlocked, we can grab them and move them around as much as we need. So the first thing that we're going to do is establish our optical center. So we need this guide to fall into the very middle of this artboard. So if we have our snap to guides selected, or if you have smart guides, then it's probably going to snap it to the center, and you can trust that's where it is. If you don't trust it, go ahead and bring it all the way over to the edge, and you can type in the full width of your artboard. So mine is 36 inches, and I can just hit tab, and then that'll snap it to the edge there. And then since I know that my halfway point is 50%, in that same text field, I can type in 50% and then hit tab to jump out of that text field. And now my guide has snapped to the center, the vertical center there. Okay. So now we remember that our horizontal axis is 46% down from the top. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the top ruler, pull it down to the bottom. It looks like over here, my y-axis snapped perfectly to the 24 inches. If it didn't, just type in 24 inches in the y text field. And then from there, I can do 46% and hit tab. And now this is my optical center. All right, pretty cool. So next, let's go ahead and establish our B area. That's gonna be from the left side of our artboard over. This is going to show how far over our top and bottom groups of text are going to be from the left edge of our canvas. So that's going to be 17% of my horizontal axis. I'm sorry, of my horizontal measurement. So I'm going to grab a ruler. I'm going to snap it over here to the edge. Make sure that it says 36 inches exactly, or whichever dimension yours are. And then from there, in this x-axis, I'm going to type in 17%, and hit tab. So now it says that 17% is 6.2 inches, all right? So let me go ahead and grab another ruler from that left, grab another guide from that left ruler, snap it over to the 36. Now this time, instead of entering a percentage, I can hit minus, just the dash there, 6.12. And now that is exactly 17% from the right side of my artboard. Great. So now let's establish our A measurement right here. So I'm going to pull a horizontal guide down from my horizontal ruler at the top there, grab it all the way to the bottom of the artboard. It shows my y-axis here that it's snapped to 24. So this one is 15%. Of the shortest axis. So that's why I'm going into my Y field here, because that's my shortest axis. So I'm going 15% there, and I'll just hit tab, and now it's snapped up there. So it says for me, 15% of this is 3.16. So now I also know that I need to do 15% in this area and this area as well, but it's the same 15% as the one that we just created. So that means it's going to be 3.6 inches. So I'm going to grab a guide from my left side ruler there and drop it at the zero x-axis here. And then from there, I can hit plus 3.6 and hit tab. And there it is. Look at that. And I know that it's correct because this is a perfect square right here. Okay. Now I'll grab this side over here, snap it to the other end, and you guessed it, this time I'll enter minus 3.6. Oop, there we go, perfect. Looking really good so far. So next we need to establish this 29% down, okay? And I think you're getting the hang of it now. I'm gonna grab a horizontal one, place it on the bottom there so that it says 24 inches in my y-axis, and I'm going to enter 29% in that Y field there. So 29%, and there it is. So this right here is my first area of copy. So I'll fill that in so you can just have a visual to look at it. Okay, great. So the next one's going to be another 33% down. So I'm sorry, 38% down. So I can figure this out by either making one that's 33% up from the bottom, which is very easy. That's going to be 67%. I was the amount I would type into that text box, or I can add these two together to get 67%. So I'm going to use my selection tool. I'm going to grab into that ruler there, take it to the bottom, and then in my Y field, type in 67% and tab. There we go. So now this is my big area where my main information is going to go. And let's go ahead and give that a fill. Great. All right. And then next, this is the easiest way for figuring out this bottom section. With rectangles, you can click and drag a rectangle with your rectangle tool. And I'm just going to make sure it's up to the line there. Great. And then from there, in the transform area, instead of messing with our X and Y axis, we're going to mess with our height box here. And in this one, we will put 50% there and hit tab. And then just snap it up to that line. Great. So now these are the fields where you're going to enter your text. And your sign is going to be visually balanced, and it's going to have this beautiful negative space around all your text so that they're working to complement each other. And you just can't lose with this natural layout formula. Thanks so much for watching.